you were at spring training when all this came down. How crazy was it to just break camp and have no more baseball?
Yeah, it was definitely weird. We were playing Thursday afternoon. There was some chatter out there about, you know, something was going to happen, but nobody was really expecting it to just end. And so we're playing Thursday afternoon. The game ends. We won. We were playing the Florida Marlins at home at Roger Dean Stadium. We're walking off the field. The crowd was giving us a standing ovation. All the players, everybody's like, wow, it was just kind of eerie. Then we came into the clubhouse, and that's when they told us that they had postponed spring. Next thing you know, it was kind of like, okay, this is real. Excuse me. And they had go ahead and sent guys home. You know, I got on a plane the next day and flew back here to New Hampshire. So it was definitely an eerie situation. And it was definitely something that, you know, again, like anything else and everything else going on in our world right now, unprecedented.
How are all your family and friends in New Hampshire making out through this?
Yeah, so far so good. Everybody's doing the things they're supposed to be doing, staying at home, and they're self-isolating and doing those things. So, you know, so far, thank the Lord that everybody's been healthy, staying safe, and hopefully we can get through this as soon as and quickly as we can.
I've been asking all the guys, what's your haircut situation? You're wearing a hat, so that might be the answer right there.
My hair is definitely getting long, a lot longer than it's been in the past. So, hence the hat. Go ahead and cover it up.
You gonna let anybody touch it that's not a professional?
Nope. I trim around my ears a little bit here and there, but no, I'm gonna go ahead and let it go until it's until I get back to the people that do it for me regularly.
I bet you had a mullet back when you played at Trinity High School on the hockey team. You might be heading in that direction.
Yeah, I sure did. Yeah, I mean, back in those days, you're allowed to. I made the varsity team my freshman year, and they were able to still do like the not hazing, but you know what I mean, like where they shaved the freshmen's heads. If you made it, you had to get your head shaved, and I had a big old mullet with long hair, and the senior shaved my head bald, and it was definitely a different look. I haven't had a mullet since then, but I definitely had one.
That's a great story. So just looking ahead to what might happen with baseball season, we know it's delayed at least 8 weeks. Do you anticipate we're going to have some sort of Major League Baseball season this year?
I sure hope so. And I think, you know, again, whatever is safe is important, but they're definitely doing everything they can to try to get it to happen. I hear the same rumors that everybody else hears, and that's, you know, they're talking about May, they're talking about June, they're talking about Florida, they're talking about Arizona. I mean, there's all kinds of different things that are coming out there. I don't think anybody's going to know until they know truly the safety of the whole thing. So I don't think you want to get involved into it, get everybody going, and then all of a sudden next year, you know, you got a whole team sick and they can't play and they have to shut it down again. I think there's going to have to be something in place for health and safety, of course, but it's important to get going. I think there's going to be an opportunity to. I hope there's an opportunity to, no matter how long we have to play. I know there's a lot of people missing baseball, including myself. So hopefully they can figure something out. But again, safety is first to everybody around the teams and the public and everything else. So once we can get that situated, hopefully we can get something going.
Very good. Well, Chris, thanks for joining us, and stay safe for sure.
Thanks, Jamie. You too. Take care.